Now, powering homes isn't the only thing that solar energy is being used for. Amazingly, it's also being used in oil extraction, saving on the use of precious natural gas.
Now, in an amazing combination of new and old tech, solar energy is actually being used to extract fossil fuels. Well, I met up with Rod McGregor, the president and chief executive of GlassPoint Solar, to find out more.
If you look at where energy is consumed in the whole well to wheels, what's generally not known is that a huge amount of energy is consumed producing the oil in the first place. So to give you an example, if you look at all of the enhanced oil recovery in the world today, that uses more energy than would be required to power every home in the six largest states in the US. So if you make small changes upstream, they can be much larger than the very large changes downstream. So there is an opportunity to make a huge difference. For example, if you did just 1% of EOR with solar, you would reduce carbon emissions by more than every electric vehicle ever built.
Wow. I mean, I guess this is maybe the question for the person at home, but if you already had the solar technology, why not use that directly to power things rather than extracting the fossil fuels? I mean, we, in theory, are trying to move away from fossil fuels long term anyway.
Why not do both? I think these things are not mutually exclusive. We think desktop solar is a fantastic technology and absolutely should be deployed, but that's no reason to preclude making big changes upstream where even more energy and hence more emissions can be reduced.
This project is currently underway in Oman. I know long-term projections say it may help with over 200,000 new jobs there in the country. Tell me a little bit about the project in Oman and why you chose that area in particular.
Petroleum Development Oman is the leading oil provider in the country of Oman. It's a joint venture with Shell and Total. And they've been researching solar enhanced oil recovery for over a decade. And the motivation for that research is the amount of gas that's burned to produce oil. Now that sounds like a contradiction. How do you burn gas to produce oil? The basic mechanism is they burn gas, heat water, to produce steam, which is injected in an oil well. At the moment, they burn roughly one quarter of all the country's gas is burned to produce oil. That's a huge resource. It's essentially being wasted. Now, Oman would love to not have to burn that gas, but still have the oil. And that's where Solar EOR comes in. So back in 2011, we started a project with PDO. We completed it in December 2012. And since then, it's been running every day, producing solar steam to help produce oil. And we're in discussion now about what the next stage would be.
And I mean, I guess that's the big question, the next stage. I mean, is this something that you might see rolled out to other Gulf states, other Gulf states in the region?
Well, even the rollout within Oman would be substantial, and that's where the 200,000 jobs figure comes from. That widespread deployment of EOR, solar EOR, within Oman could create 200,000 jobs. It could save half a billion cubic feet of gas per day. That half a billion cubic feet of gas per day would be reinjected into the Oman economy to create all sorts of value. Now that same picture replicated throughout the Gulf, because with the exception of Qatar, gas is a scarce and valuable resource everywhere in the Gulf. And Kuwait and Bahrain have also recently announced plans to develop their heavy oil assets, which will require steam injection. And then the question is, where will the gas come to support all that steam? If you look at Kuwait's statements on their 2020 goals for heavy oil, once they've implemented that, they'll be burning more gas for EOR than for power generation. Again, just to give you a sense of scale of what we're talking about. So if you could use solar for that and save all of that gas and hence save all of the emissions, that's a tremendous opportunity. And also, it's about half the cost of burning gas to do the same thing.
I mean, it looks like there's savings all around to be had using this technology. I guess the big question is, why has this not been adopted, this technology not been adopted until now? Is it just simply not available or just the two not put together?
I think it's not generally, historically, it's not been generally recognized that solar EOR was such a big opportunity. And most solar designs are optimized for making electricity, which is a very different technical challenge than making steam for enhanced oil recovery. So these systems are the first ones ever designed for that application. They're designed to operate in the Gulf, where it's humid and sandy and dusty, as opposed to in California or Spain, where it's very clean and dry. And they're designed to accept oil field water. And most fundamentally, they're designed to be cheap enough to deploy. Solar electricity in most markets is subsidized, but no one's subsidizing oil production. And so we have to compete fundamentally with the price of gas. So these systems are about one half the cost of previous solar designs.